my whole thing is, you know, what sparked, what's bothering me, you know, what ticked me off this morning with this Blaze Man person, and it's with other people in general. It's like, though, I think honesty really lacks in the churches, whatever it, wherever it, now, I can only speak for where I've been, and that's in the Pentecostal church. It lacks, and I've experienced where you cannot share with anybody what you're going through because it's the fear of, oh, they're going to look at you differently, kick you out, and I've been through it. And so my thing is, why not watch this video, and I commend what Tony did, is because he was being honest. Honest. And I think people, that scares people, you know, honesty. When someone is real, because like, oh, snap, now, oh, wow. I can, you can walk in front of me, walk and look, talk in my face. Nothing is hidden. You know my stuff. So what? And what? So my thing is, what? They're now going to bash him because, oh, he said he's gay. He's a, okay. And those who assumed he was gay before, now that he has opened his mouth and said it, okay, what has changed? What has changed? Because he confessed it? That makes no sense.
Doesn't change him as an artist, doesn't change his talent, doesn't change what he can do and what he does. It just changes the perception that other people have of him. And unfortunately, people judge him for it.
And that's the whole thing. And then if you want to, you know, so we're going to throw these scriptures, judge not, lest he be. Yo, look, my thing is, before anybody can say, look in the mirror and tell yourself what you're trying to tell me. And then when you have convinced yourself and you're free from sin, then you can talk to me.
I don't think such a person exists.
It's not a, because he has came, he has come out and he's been honest with his sexuality. No, that does not give anyone to say, oh, it's not a thing where it's saying, he is saying, where I believe, I don't take it to me to believe he's saying it's okay to be gay. No, he is being honest with himself and God, himself. And this is what I'm trying to say, it's your personal walk. He didn't come out and say, oh, okay, come on to me, all you gays. He was being honest with himself and God in public. How many people can do that? And that's what I commend him on. When the church can be totally honest, then you can throw scriptures to me left, right, and center. You can do it. When the church follows everything the Bible is saying, then you can say something to me. But as for me and my house, I am going to seek him for myself. I'm going to ask him things I need to know for myself, for my walk. Because people fail to realize, guess what? We all have a destination. But we all not going to take the same road. Don't mean I'm not going to get there. You may get there a little faster. Shoot, I could walk outside and drop dead. You may take 10 years till you die of an illness. But guess what? We all going to get there somehow. And in the meantime, guess what? If you want to walk together, walk together. But don't try to stab me in my face and kick me in my shin while we walking. Don't do it.
I like what you said in the video. I can't get you into heaven and you can't get me in as well.
But people, I don't think people really realize that.
No, they don't. I think they automatically assume that if whatever they're thinking, that everyone else should be thinking, that their ideals should be everyone else's. People don't realize that no matter what kind of, like we were talking about before, in any particular group, even though they might be acting and saying the exact same things, it doesn't mean that they relate to those things or think about those things in the exact same way.
Exactly.
It's not possible. We're individuals. We, that's the right word. We accept things, we see things through our own personal experiences, and no matter, even two twins who were raised in the exact same family, in the exact same church, in the exact same way, with the same teachers, with the same everything, I can almost guarantee you that it's not possible that they think the exact same way,
it's
because certain things that happen in life, certain friends, certain people, we experience things, and because of the way we experience them, that's how we interpret the rest of our lives.
There you go.
And there is not a single, not single, there are no two people who have experienced everything exactly the same. Even if they're twins, even if they're in the same family, they still have different experiences. So how are you going to tell me that because of your experience, this is what you believe, and therefore I should
believe
it
as well? You know, but then, you know, the argument could be, oh, but the Bible says, look, you can take the Bible, have two people sit side by side and read it, and they come up with two different interpretations.
Well, obviously, come on.
What are you going to tell them? Oh, you're wrong?
Even
what?
Even you, do you remember that a little while back you kept on pulling up scripture out of the Bible to to the pastor that you were talking about, where it was actually, you know, you were quoting and saying that if you interpret it in this way, it'll mean something completely different than the way they interpret. A lot of the stuff, when it's such a massive amount of information, can always be interpreted in different ways. Again, we interpret it depending on what our experiences are. But if it's open to interpretation, there is no way that you can treat it as a fact. It can't be a fact if it could be interpreted in two different ways.
So yeah. Yeah, this is my whole take on it, you know. Anyway, y'all could drop your comments, join in. Blah, blah, blah. All right? Peace, peace.